activity. That's everybody doing. I'm doing that real talk through time. We have a reorder that's special for you. Welcome to the 21st annual Martin Luther King Jr. Remembrance Day being here at the Las Vegas Church. I'd like to thank the Church of God in town, for so many people. If you take a moment and think about the program, I don't begin to thank everybody that makes this successful each year. So thank you very much. With that, I'd like to take just a moment to ask the members of the Black History Committee with me to just stand and be recognized for a moment. If you can still get up after walking. Just put your best. Thank you. Speech, and Martin Luther King was assassinated. they never break speech. They now walk in at the close of the Civil War, gave the second inaugural address. Not too many weeks after that, he was assassinated. But what he had to say seemed important. There's a bullet. He said, with malice toward men, with charity for all, to do all which they achieve and cherish a just and lasting peace among ourselves and with all nations. I believe Martin Luther King took this vision even further, and so it is my privilege tonight to invite you to embrace and experience this vision. God bless you. Good evening. I'm Donna Henry, and I'm the Chancellor of the University of Virginia's College at Rise. And on behalf of our college, I welcome you to our community's annual remembrance of Dr. Martin Luther King's life and legacy. First, I'd like to thank all of the people who have made this special evening possible. First, I'd like to thank today's speakers and presenters, the Black History Committee at UVA-Rise, and other volunteers who've worked hard to provide this outstanding program. Greetings to the audience, to UVA-Rise students, faculty, and staff. It's so good to see all of you here. Greetings to members of the Church of God and the Rise Baptist Church. And greetings to all the congregations present with us this evening. And greetings to many old and new friends who are seeing out in the audience. It's so wonderful each year to see our community come together to honor Dr. King. The committee chooses a theme for the program every year, and this year's theme, as you've heard, is peace and brotherhood. Peace and brotherhood. What do these words mean to you? What images do they hold in your mind? And what thoughts do they bring to your mind? How far have we come in achieving peace and brotherhood since Dr. King's assassination nearly 50 years ago? How much further have we yet to go? And what can I do to help move this on? What can each of us do? And what can we all do together to advance peace, justice, and human rights in this community, in our nation, and in our world? Dr. King's teachings changed our nation. He changed people's hearts, and he changed people's minds. He inspired hope. He inspires hope. That led to today. He helped us to dream, he awakened our nation's spirit, and he raised our collective consciousness. He helped us believe. Throughout his advocacy, he was mindful that the change that he himself envisioned might not happen in his lifetime, yet he kept pushing for progress. I believe that Dr. King had a constant belief that peace and brotherhood are achievable. This belief never left Dr. King's side, and it should never leave our sides. How do we make progress toward those ideals? Let's talk to one another. Let's listen to one another. Let's work together. And let's be in service to each other. Most of all, let's see the humanity in one another and come together as partners for peace. As I've said every year, I'm so proud of our college and this community nestled in the mountains of Southwest Virginia worked together so diligently to ensure that Dr. King's life and teachings are honored and remembered. We honor him not only on this day of remembrance each year, but throughout the year, as demonstrated by the numerous ways we learn and live together. Like many of you, I look forward to tonight's program, and I thank you all for coming.
Thank you. Thank you.
Freedom, but by drinking from the cup of hatred. And he said, the mountains, no blessing which has engulfed the Negro community, was not lead us to distrust our white people. He said, for we are not white brothers as enemies of their prophecy to be made in the writing. And as many of the prophets here today, he said, appear to realize that their destiny is tied up in our destiny. And they appear to realize that their freedom is bound to our freedom. He said, we cannot look alone. I began to realize that the back end was never against people. He won't even hate anybody. He loved our people, but he wanted what he wanted was for us, was for us to come together. Yes, it was the truth. 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 Slave owners would be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. The real life freedom to reign, when we let it reign from every village, every family, every state, every city, we will be able to speed up the building of all God's children. Black men, white men, Gentile, Protestant, Catholic, all be able to join in the heaven.
She said,
these problems. He thinks that all of these church people go to pray and go over and listen to what that preacher preaches.
Thank you.
person threatened him. Maybe that person you need to think about here. We need to start changing business. Thank you.
I'm going to go to the next one.
sow. You don't have to have a college degree to sow. You only need a heart full of grace and a soul generated by love. So make sure when you leave that you do your heart thing. And you can start tonight out the parking lot. You don't have to wait till tomorrow. Now, this next one is a gospel group called the Staple Singers. Anybody's in here? Anybody's in here? It's like three tries to make the marks that they're singing about. And it took three tries to get protection for them to march from Alabama to the state capitol. And over 600 marched on this march. So during the time they tried to do that march, this song was written called Freedom Highway. And it started a little church. And it started traveling with everybody. And I just think it was highly relevant today as it was then. So this is the Freedom Promise. Thank you. thank everybody tonight for coming and lifting one of my hands to everybody that they've already spoken. We're going to close out the program with Michelle on the council. Everybody, please stand. Let me know who's hearing. And hopefully, we'll get somebody that can sing besides me to bring this out. Anybody else want to come up? You're welcome to do so. Thank you.
right, Kirk, come visit sometime.